Hi, in this video we will explore options to export to Google Drive and use the Google Sheets application to strip down the data from the model by using SheetLink, upload to cloud, modify data and update the model. Okay, if I open the SheetLink, more or less in all of these tabs, you have option to export to Google Drive. So what we can do, as an example, we can find, let's say, walls. Okay. You'll find the walls. Let's reset the search. We can see that we selected walls and we have a list of parameters. So let's see if some walls are structural. Let's pick maybe the level base constraint, and that is it for now. And we will order the parameters by using these buttons. Okay, so what we can do, we can click export. And in this point in time, we can decide, do we export to Excel or export to Google? You need to authenticate. I will use this account. It's a dummy account, so we can upload the files and you can edit, we can download. Let's see in the sheet link. And you will see that now we have access to this folder structure. So you see the shared folder, because shared between multiple Gmail accounts is always on top. And you see my drive, one things that are specific or folder structure that is specific for my Google account. Okay, let's make this one a bit bigger. And let's explore what we see here. SheetLink repository, okay. We have SheetLink repository, but we have also SheetLink folder. Let's go to the SheetLink folder just for a second to see the structure. SheetLink, if we open, we see this folder structure. This is a shared folder. So we will open SheetLink and we can compare. So this is my folder structure. At this point in time, I can decide that I want to use my SheetLink repository, give the file name, for example, all walls. Okay, something meaningful for you. And you can decide which format you want to export. We recommend use XLSX because it's a kind of standard format. So, but you can use also Google Sheets. You have options to search folders or search files. For example, I can search air and it will find. Okay, let's export now, upload, give it a second. It will upload and all walls are now here. You see modified date. Now what I can do, I can go to my Google Drive, my drive, SheetLink repository, and I see now all walls. Okay, what you can do, either right-click or double-click, but I will open with Google Sheets. It will open in a separate tab. And you can see that we can see our content. What we can do, we can filter, for example, only entry level. And as an example, on entry level, maybe we want all walls to be structural for some reason. Let's pretend that we have a case study here, just for the sake of demonstration of the tool. And we can reset the bring back all other levels, and we can see that we successfully modified. Now, one rule of thumb, Google will say that it's automatically saved, okay? But to be 100% sure, you just close the tab and it will be immediately saved in a Google Drive. Okay, so it's saved. What we can do now, we can close this one. We can use import. From Google, we can open my drive, go to SheetLink repository, all walls, import, model updated successfully. So let's inspect just briefly. Let's use one filter. Let's find the category walls. Let's find the parameter that is called S structural, and that is yes, type of yes. And we see the walls. Let's control A here and show highlighted elements. It will select them. So all walls that have a base level to be entry level will be now structural. So to recap quickly, what we can do in SheetLink, in any of these tabs, we can always export data either to Excel file on your local machine or export to Google. Use Google as a Google Drive as a storage or Google Sheets as a editing tool. You make modifications and just use the, in the end, import from Google option, and you will update your model. Thank you and see you in the next video. Bye.